Yo, what is up, guys? Welcome to Season 3 of Fortnite. I'm finally making a settings video, giving you guys an idea of what the best settings to run in Season 3 are. I do need to quickly explain how aim assist works, because I'm basically recommending pretty much the opposite thing from what I recommended during Season 2. I recommended people using linear. I've since switched up to exponential, and I'm going to break down why I think that is, and why if you use exponential settings in this season, it's going to feel like your aimbot, and it's going to feel like you get way more tags in box fights and at range than your opponents that you fight. And keep in mind, a lot of people are still stuck on linear and believe it's better, but I really do think exponential is the go-to input method right now in the game. And we're going to get into why that is. So Verony Bros has a really great video. I'll link his channel in the description over to check him out. Also makes controller content. But he's got a really great video showing the old version of aim assist before it started getting nerfed. Just watch this.
I'm not even touching my right stick there. And then if I'm barely touching my right stick, it tracks me towards
So you can see this auto-rotation?
A little bit. Yeah, moving my right stick in circles, and you can see how it's basically just pulling me to Bad Wolf. And, you know, if he jumps
like, see that
head,
jump up and it auto-tracks?
On his head.
That's the old system. Now, here's the thing. Linear settings before basically would have that level of aim assist. And so if you have linear turned on, the way linear works is it uses raw input. So if you start off and you take your joystick and you just immediately push it all the way to one side, you're immediately going to be spinning at full acceleration. Whereas if you have exponential and you hit it all the way to the side, it's going to start slow and speed up. And basically what exponential does is not only how much you input on your joystick affects your movement speed, but also how long you've input on your joystick. So if I'm on linear, that makes me able to do these like really fast twitchy moves. And it makes a lot of my builds, like, I'll say a little bit more consistent once you get used to it. However, because you're so twitchy, it's really hard to make like little tiny accurate micro adjustments, especially at range. And now because the aim assist has been nerfed so much in this season, keep in mind that footage I just showed you from Roadie Bros is no longer the case. There's now no auto rotation when somebody jumps up over you. It will now no longer follow the person. You'll get a little bit of slowdown, which basically means that as you get onto a person, the aim slows down a little bit, but it's drastically reduced. It's about 50% of what it was in the past season. And so because you're not getting any more aim assist slowdown, I believe that exponential settings are the way to go. Because what exponential allows you to do is it allows you to still be fast, because once you're inputting for any length of time, right, your joystick kind of picks up the pace. But then when you're trying to aim at range, a little tiny adjustment, you're able to do little tiny movements, right, at range. And it's because, and in close quarters, you're able to do micro adjustments as well. The reason being is that not only, again, when you hit your stick, does it take the actual input, but it also depends on the time that you input on your stick. So if you give like a little tiny tap on your joystick, you get a little tiny bit of movement. It allows for much more micro adjustments. And because we don't have aim assist near the same level now in this season, that makes up for it. Basically, being able to use that micro tweaking helps so much. And that's basically why I would personally recommend exponential in this season over linear. Now, I know a lot of you guys are really, really used to linear building. Linear does, again, because it's immediate, because it's immediate input, it makes your builds feel a little bit more consistent. One thing you can do, if exponential is feeling slow, you can, again, up your build mode sensitivity and your edit mode sensitivity. I personally feel like, again, on Expo, I'm able to do edits a little bit more consistent, but my builds, my actual, like, ramps and cones, I still think we're more consistent on linear, but I still think at the end of the day, aim is so important in Fortnite, especially in the charged shotgun meta, basically where we no longer have like 200 pumps. We have to charge up our shots, and that makes a little bit of the building aspect less important than being able to charge up your gun and aim it and be consistent with your shots. I think it's really more important now than ever to be good with aim. So for my settings right now on exponential, I'm rocking 1.7 build mode sensitivity, 1.8 build mode sensitivity. If you knew my settings from last season, you know they haven't changed that much, but I'm on 40% horizontal speed and 40% vertical. I lowered mine. My old settings last season were that. That's literally all I've changed from last season, but I do think it's important to lower it down because, again, now that we're getting less aim assist, once you get on target, your aim slows down less. Your aim will actually be faster on target. So by having a low base speed, you're not going to be overcompensating. You're not going to be over flicking when you get onto players. I think it's the way to go. Just notch it down a little bit. Obviously, you don't want to have a super, super low sensitivity because you'll just never be able to follow people in box fights. But I think a few notches lower than where you were in the previous season, if you were on a sensitivity that felt great, just take it down a little bit. And you'll be surprised how much better your aim feels. I have 20% ADS look and vertical speed. Again, because exponential allows you to use time, the amount of time you input on your stick to slow down your aim, I think you can rock a higher like look speed. And then obviously I have 100% aim assist strength. My move stick dead zone, I'm on 24%. My look stick, I'm on 9%. Your look stick, you can basically go as low as you can. But I personally like rocking a high move stick, and it's actually for a weird reason. The thing is, well, it's not a weird reason. It makes a lot of sense. I used to rock a really low move stick, and then I thought about it. I saw my accuracy had dropped off at range. Here's the thing. If you're dead still in Fortnite, you get really great accuracy, believe it or not. But if you have any bit of movement, look what happens to my blue. So if I have any kind of stick drift at all in the slightest, it screws up my shot. It makes it inaccurate. So what I did was I raised my left dead zone so that I would never have unintentional movement on my left stick. Basically, I made it so that even though I was tapping my stick a little bit, it wouldn't necessarily move my character, and then because of that, decrease my accuracy. So by having a high move stick dead zone, it is actually better for accurate shots. I hope that helps you out, guys. I got some incredible gameplay today using some of the new mythic weapons, and again, my aim is kind of cracked out, so you guys want to enjoy that and watch that. That'd be lit. Also, the loser fruit skin is in the game right now, and it's a good skin, dude. They did a really good job with this skin. It's 1,500 V-Bucks. If you want to use code Upshaw to support me, that'd be lit. Appreciate it. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Kind of upset I'm not going to make that. Forgetting how little match you actually get in regular pubs. Charged shotgun, man, is underrated right now. I feel like everybody doesn't think it's any good. And that shit is good, man. Okay, so that's a real player. Baby! Always get excited when I see the gold one, but it's just the gold, it's not the mythic. Frown gone, dude. So stupid. Shut up in his box and then just grapple myself out of there. Idiot. Nobody's really carrying that much mats, but I think, honestly, a lot of it's got to do with the zones, man. The zones are, like, so water-based. I feel like a lot of kids just don't even get the opportunity to farm mats. I saw it. When I hear kids trying to freaking tack shock on me, I literally don't even care. I don't even care. It's so weak that it doesn't bother me. Later, bud. Oh no, he had the green one. We're gonna go sub mode. Man, there's some weird kid who I swear chatbots me like every day, dude. It is bizarre, man. I don't get it. I mean, I guess it's just like an example. It means I'm doing good. But it's weird. It's just like, what a way to waste your money, bro. What's this guy doing? See, like, right there, I'm letting go because I feel like I already have won the fight, but I haven't actually shot the gun. I toggle basically right before the moment, the millisecond before I've actually shot it. Serpent EU! Hey, you! Get shit on, mate! Get shit on! Look at this cranking, bro. Oh my god.